Okay, we test the first approach, the UART with the pooling mode. Then we test the UART with the interrupt, and now we also test the UART with DMA. Then we look on the UART. We again set the F4, 401, 401 LQFP 64 pin package, STM32F401 RET, which is on my Nucleo kit. And for the DMA, I will use again the UART1 in the asynchronous mode on the pin PA9 and PA10. Then I have these pins connected together with my cable. Yes, I have my pin PA10, PA9 and PA10 connected together with the cable. Okay, from the clock on, from the pinout, this is everything what I need. Only two pins reserved for my UART. On the clock configuration, I am also okay with the 16 MHz. Then we move to the main configuration. When we have the USART, we check the parameters. Again, I am okay with the 115,200 baud. It's everything perfect. But now I will not change the NVIC. This will be the same, but here I will use the DMA. Then I add the DMA stream. I select what will be the direction. Then I will create one for the transmit. I can select the stream, sometimes more streams, and the direction is from memory to peripheral, which is okay because this is for the transmit. Then during the transmit, I will read the data from my memory and I put it into the USART, which is the periphery. Then the direction is okay. Also, the priority now doesn't matter because I have only one, I will have two DMA streams, but they will not run in the concurrent way. Then it's okay. Then here I will select the receive, the stream 2. I can use also stream 5, but I don't want. And the direction is from the peripheral to memory, which is okay for the reception. What I need to check here if is here checked the memory increment for the both USARTs, and the rest can be left unchanged, normal mode, NordCycler mode. It's okay. Then I can save here this one. I can change my settings into my examples. I will name it UR3 and I will use the IR. Everything is okay. Then I can generate my project. Let him to open my project. Okay, my project is opened. Then we can cross-check our user section, the main.c. We can see there is something new in initializing. Also, there is the DMA in it. We first check the USART in it or UART in it. It's completely the same like before with the interrupts, but we have here the DMA in it. What we have here, we enabling the DMA interrupts. This is necessary to notify us when the DMA ends. But here is missing the DMA initialization because how we configure the DMA. But because the DMA is here the related periphery to the USART, then we have here in the MSP initialization, we have the configuration of the pins, but here we have also the DMA initialization. It's the again the same structure. We have the DMA handle. We set the instance from this handle, and then we fill the init structure like on the usart. There we set the direction that we want to increment the memory, that the data size and memory size it's in the bytes, and the mode is normal, and then we call the DMA HL DMA init. But something new and here important, we need to link together the USART and the DMA. Then for this we use the macro HL underscore underscore HL underscore link DMA, which links together the handle from UART and also the handle from the DMA. Then the DMA knows which peripheral using this DMA and UART knows which DMA to use. This is all from this part. We can also look into the interrupts, because we're using the interrupts now also to notify the DMA that DMA ends. Again, we have here the DMA handler and we're using the HL handle. But now, where to find the callbacks? Because we're using here now the DMA interrupts, we need to search for the DMA callbacks. The answer is no, because the DMA don't have their own callbacks. The DMAs using the callbacks from USART. Then in our case, when we're searching for callbacks, we will not search into the DMA, we will still use the UART callbacks. Then here we search for the underscore underscore weak, not MSP in it, not this one, but for example the transmit complete callback. I can put it into my main. And also here will be a reception complete callback. Then I will use also the reception complete callback. Here I put again my while to notify me about the end of this of the reception. And you can see, because we linked together the DMA and UART, then this is the reason why the DMA can use the USART or UART callbacks. Then we don't need to search for the DMA callbacks. We only using the one type of the callbacks. And I will also create two buffers. One for the transmission. And second for the reception. Okay, the buffers are prepared. Then I can do the same thing like in the interrupt lab. I start with the HL underscore UART. And first I will call the reception, but now with the DMA, don't forget on the DMA word. I again put the handle name, it will be H, I think UART1. The second parameter, if I'm not sure, I will go to the definition into the C. Second parameter is the how many the pointer on the data. And last parameter, the third parameter is the size. How many bytes I want to receive. Then it will be here the buffer. Buffer for receiving and 10 bytes, why not? And then I will put the HL UART, the transmit with the DMA. Again, the DMA must be there. The H UART1, the buffer for transmit. And 10 bytes. Okay, now I can compile my code. Maybe I forget to change also the optimization, why not? Here in the compiler optimization I set none. I will compile it again. And I can run my debug. Okay, this is okay. I can put here the breakpoint, and I can put here these two variables into the watch. Here I can show it. Add to watch. They are now here on the right side. You can see the reception buffer is empty now. The transmission buffer is full. Then when I run the code, you can see that we receive what we are sending. I can make also test. When I start again, I reset the microcontroller. I disconnect my cable and run it again. And you see, I never receive the bytes. I'm still waiting on the interrupt and to receive 10 bytes. If I connect it again back, I get this, and I have here the correct by number of bytes. Then this was the DMA example with the USART. It's not so more difficult than the interrupt. Okay, we can look on the DMA with the UART. With the theoretical point of view, we can summarize what we know. What is new here is the DMA initialization. The UART initialization is the same. In the DMA initialization, we only enable the DMA and we enable the interrupts from the DMA, because the DMA must notify us that the DMA ends. Okay, it's not necessary, but otherwise you need to always check the status of the periphery. Then definitely the DMA initialization is in the MSP init, which is now new. It was not in the previous initialization. It's below usually the pin initialization. But the important is the link between the DMA and the UART. When if we remember the UART handler, we have there the pointers to the DMA, which can point which DMA is used together with this periphery. And in the DMA handle, it's also the parent pointer, which will point back to our UART. This is only showing how looks like the DMA link DMA function, which connects together the UART handle or the defend handle, and also the handles from the DMA. But this all is done automatically inside the QPMX. Here only showing how this looks like. Then the UART handle have pointer to the DMA handles, and the DMA handles have also pointers on the UART. Then the DMA knows which periphery it's using the DMA, and the UART know which DMA he needs to use. Yes, then this is the still the same. In the interrupt, we have the interrupt handler. We using the HL DMA interrupt handler, which for us clear the flags, check how many bytes we received. But the callbacks will be always the same. Then we using the USART callbacks. We can also use now the half transfer callback. That means we are in the half of our buffer. In our case, when we receive or transmit 10 bytes, then the half transfer is the 5. And how it looks like the interrupt, the DMA is not blocking function. This means that we call the reception. If everything is okay, we end with the okay, or we end with the error. And then when we receive the byte, then we go into the interrupt. I think the automatically many of bytes we give in the interrupt handler, in the HL interrupt handle, we check if we have the DMA error. If yes, we end up in the USART error callback. If not, we check if we have in the half transfer interrupt. If yes, we call the half transfer interrupt. If not, we check the transfer complete interrupt. If yes, we go into the half transfer, in the transfer complete callback, and we end the interrupt. Then the USART with the DMA is completely not blocking. What is the difference between the interrupt? In the interrupt version, we get the interrupt each byte which we received. In the DMA, we get the interrupt only in the half transfer or in the transfer complete. This means that this more offloads the CPU. This is reason why to use the DMA.